Okay, guys, so sorry for not posting a lot for Vlogmas. I just wasn't in the mood and I had a lot of stuff going on. So tomorrow, aka Friday, my mom is going to get her prosthetic leg, which I'm super excited about. So yeah, I am excited about that, you guys. We are at TJ Maxx. I'm in the bathroom. I didn't go. Just came in here to like vlog because my mom was in the bathroom. So yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow because it's been like here and there vlogs, but that's it. Woo! See you guys tomorrow. Peace. Okay, so we are here at the prosthesis. So we're gonna be here for half a day. So, any thoughts?
No.
You nervous?
Yeah.
It is Friday, and we are. Well, she is nervous. Mm-hmm. I would be too. So yeah, I'll see you guys when the doctor comes. Woo!
If that one starts giving you any issues, we can always change to something different. The main issues I have with this liner, like I said, just a little bit harder on the skin.
Okay.
You might get some irritation around the top edge or even in your groin area.
Yeah.
But then once that happens, it'll go away and probably won't happen anymore.
Okay.
But I typically have that type of issue with like Caucasian type skin. So
the liner is a little bit long to start because this plastic can sometimes dig into you.
Oh, okay.
And then having some cushioning over the plastic, this improves the comfort a little bit. Okay.
Okay.
So again, the valve's dead center there. Mm-hmm. I'm going to just take this and push it on like that. And you're already helping me out by making sure that slipped over the top. I can just flip it over there.
Okay.
And then I'm just going to push on you, okay? So it's kind of on already, all right? You see how those rings are making contact in there?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get a walker so you can stand up.
Okay.
We're actually going to use this stand to achieve what she's talking about here.
Okay.
So what you're going to need to do is when you stand up with your amputated side, you got to use this butt muscle and pull your leg behind you and stand on this platform.
Okay.
It's very common when you stand up, your leg's going to want to be here. Like all that stretching we talked about,
yeah.
It's going to be here, but you got to use your muscle to bring it back behind you.
Okay.
So we're about to stand up, and then with the walker, you're going to take your leg, bring it back behind you, and just stand on this right here.
Okay.
I'm going to raise it up or down to get you kind of level.
Okay.
As a starting point. Okay.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
Just one step stand up. And yeah, just push straight down on there.
Like that?
Yep. And just go up and down like 3 times for me. All the way up and then down. I'm gonna raise this up for you, Valanda, okay?
Okay.
Wanna push down? Okay. Is that a little too tall there, you think? A hair?
Yeah.
All right, take some weight off the... Stand like that for me.
Okay.
So the way we check height is I find your hip bones, and if one hip's higher than the other, it kind of tells me what we're looking at here as far as height, right?
Okay.
I'm gonna check it from behind you, so I'm gonna be touching your hips here, okay? Well, it's pretty close, the starting point, I think.
Uh-huh.
So now that you're standing there, is there anything bugging you in the socket that's really uncomfortable or painful that you can identify?
Just this is digging in right here on my thigh.
Okay.
I think my thigh is a little too fat for that area.
We just call it extra tissue is what we call it, okay?
That's a nice way to put it.
Yeah, so take some weight off the side. I'm gonna be touching up there, okay? So push down.
Okay.
Where's it digging at the most?
Right in here. See? Right there.
Right here?
Yeah.
Just right there?
Uh-huh.
Push down. Not anything going back here at all, is it?
No, it's just that one area.
Okay.
Right where your finger is.
Alright, we can adjust some of that if we need to still. Okay. So just go ahead and have a seat there for me.
Okay.
Now this is kind of my starting point for height to build the leg on top of. So this is how we check suction. I basically grab this, I pull on your leg, make sure it holds on, okay? So I'm gonna be tugging on you here. Just relax a little bit.
Okay. Oh, wow. All
right, so it's on there, okay? Mm-hmm. To get this off, like I say, you hit this button right here,
uh-huh.
And then one hand on the plastic, one hand here, and you're gonna push it off.
Okay.
So this is my height. I gotta go glue something on here and then reinforce it with some wrap to, so it holds on. I'm gonna bolt your knee and foot to the bottom of it.
Okay.
Cool. You got your shoe in here?
It's in here.
I'm gonna steal that while you're still wearing that, and then give me about 10 minutes and we'll be right back to do this again, okay?
Okay.
Any comment, Ms. Walker?
Oh my God, it's nerve-wracking. I don't know why.
Did it feel tight?
Yeah, it was like this part, like I said, that's the only part that hurt. It just felt like it was something hard on
well, it was.
Yeah, like, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so used to, like, the gel liner. That part was hard. So I was like, oh, my goodness.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, my God. I almost cried.
Really?
Yeah, like, it's bittersweet.
Yeah.
So it's unfortunate that this happened, but I'm happy I'm finally at this point.
Yes.
And, oh, my God, my voice is not shaking. I can tell, right? I'm shaking. I'm, like, emotional. I'm just like... I hope I don't cry. I'm about to cry already.
Alrighty. So this is the prosthetic leg.
Okay.
Just a little bit about it. First off is, one, this is the foot, okay? This is just a rubber foot cover. Inside is the actual foot, just like that, on the wall right there.
Okay.
It's just covered up by a rubber fake-looking foot.
Okay.
This foot has a lot of spring to it. You'll watch this kind of spring right here kind of compress and move like that some.
Oh, okay.
So this foot moves. You know, when our heel touches the ground, our foot goes down. This one kind of moves down a little bit too. So you'll feel some of that motion on the heel.
Mm-hmm.
As you come over, this will compress a little bit. And you can kind of, this is very springy. You might feel a little bit of give back to you when you kind of roll over the foot.
Okay.
This knee right here, it's a very safe knee. Basically, when these are not bent and they're locked out,
uh-huh.
Your knee does not bend.
Okay.
It won't bend until you physically move your weight onto the toe.
Okay.
And then when you bring your hip forward, like you're kicking a soccer ball or something, and then the knee will unlock and bend.
Oh, okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And there's a spring in there that'll help kick it out for you.
Okay.
So it's going to be like heel, toe, it's going to bend and kick out.
Okay.
You still got to use your muscles to bring it forward, though.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
So just know it's very common and people can't, you can't get the knee to bend, it's because their weight is all the way on the heel or the middle of the foot.
Okay.
But once you get your left leg out far enough in front of you, then your weight is on the toe, and then the knee unlocks and it bends.
Okay.
It just takes practice, okay?
Okay.
So that's pretty much it, all right? All we're going to do first is stand up into this thing, have you stand up, and make sure your height feels pretty level,
okay.
And then we'll go over some things to get you to take a step.
Okay.
Okay? I lower this down a little bit.
Okay.
We can work on that some more if we need to.
Okay.
But yeah, this valve goes in the front. You're just going to grab your leg like this and slide it on you like that.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to put it on with the knee bent, you can just kind of pop that.
Mm-hmm.
And then it'll bend on you for you. Just,
okay.
You know, a fist on the gray cover, it'll go down for you.
Oh,
like
okay.
That. I'll show you a trick, but when you go to sit down, you can actually kind of lean on the toe and sit down with the knee bent.
Okay.
Otherwise, you'll just sit down like this, the knee will be out there, and you'll bang that, and then it'll go down.
Okay.
It just takes a little bit of practice to get to load the toe to, for it to come down like that.
Okay.
All right.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it feels different.
Yeah.
I tried it.
Yeah.
Okay. Just push it on.
Yeah, sorry,
isn't that feeling? Whoa. I'm still going over to the...
Yeah, a little bit, but can you tell you're a lot smoother here?
Yeah.
So whenever you're walking and your knee buckles like that, it's because you're not moving fast enough. You're kind of like, okay, I'm on my heel, I'm on my foot,
yeah.
Rotate, my knee bent, okay, now I go through here. If you just kind of keep moving, it'll be fluid for you.
Okay.
And the things we're talking about and working on are like, you know, a couple weeks away.
Oh.
So we're like going in like extra innings here or bonus right now. So you're doing really well for where you're at, okay? A lot of things we're talking about and identifying, you're gonna kind of naturally smooth them out yourself just by using this knee.
Okay.
All right, so you got one more exercise in you I can show you here?
Yeah.
All right, so next exercise is just, I want you to face Kristen here and put your hands on the bars, okay? And this is another exercise you can do to strengthen this muscle right here.
Okay.
So just to demonstrate real quick, I want you to stand only on your left leg and kick this right leg out as far as you can.
Like that?
Yeah, one, just do like five of those. Two, three, four. All right, take one hand away and then do it again. All right, can you do it without any hands? Is that no hands?
Yeah.
All right. So that's because this muscle is very strong and supporting you.
Okay.
Now I want you to stand on your prosthetic leg.
Okay.
Two hands, kick your left leg out as far as you can.
Oh.
Does that feel harder or easier?
Harder.
All right, now take one hand away and try it. Right, so you can barely do it, right?
Yeah.
All right, so all I'm getting you to show is that this muscle needs to be stronger.
Okay.
Because you can stand on your good leg and kick your right leg out.
Right.
But once you stand on your prosthetic leg, you can't kick your left leg out.
Right.
And you might think like you're working your left leg muscle here, but you're actually working your right leg muscle.
Oh, okay.
By stabilizing you. So, same thing. Two hands on the bar or a walker, whatever. Uh-huh. Way on the prosthetic leg, you're gonna kick your left leg out.
Hello.
So, how'd you feel about today getting your leg?
Oh my God, it was overwhelming. Coming in today, I was really anxious and I didn't know what to expect. And I got over there, I was nervous and I was scared because he was like talking about how I had to pull things in and pull it out and how to take care of it and stuff like that. And then when I actually was walking, that's where it got really hard and I was getting upset because I didn't feel like I was doing a good job. But he kept telling me that you're doing great for someone who's did your first time because this is something people do at like 3 months from now, but you're doing it now, so you're good.
Mm-hmm.
But practice. I have to learn how to walk all over again, and with my Honey Bear's help and like everybody who's like helped me and supported me, I think I'll get to it. But it's just right now I'm like happy, but I'm super excited that I get to walk again and
run.
He made the foot like the ankle the way it is because he said that. You want to play softball again, don't you? You could run and exercise and do stuff with this once you get used to it. But we need to take baby steps and start walking and learning how to do stuff. So.
Mm-hmm. You excited?
Yeah. But I was sad because I got tired. I was tired and I was like, I was sweating and everything. I was like, oh my gosh, it's a lot of work trying to do stuff again. So, but yeah. Yay, I'm finally healed and I got my prosthetic, so it's time to walk. Yeah.
You guys, I am super excited for this journey to be over with my mom, and she doesn't have to have her leg messed up anymore. She now has her prosthetic. And it's been a long journey. It's been a long 6 months for her. So that's it for this video, you guys. I hope you like this video. Smash that like button. Subscribe. Turn on post notifications so you get notified every time I post a new video. I love you guys so much. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Bye.